Hello and welcome to Dell's Gaming. I'm Dell and this is From the Depths Designer. And we're here just on an early version of the Atlantis, just as a stable platform. Because we're going to be doing some building today that I'd mentioned in the previous video. Now this is a bit of a mixture of a building as well as a lab. I'd almost really put it as a little bit of both. Although it's for the campaign, we're going to do a bit of testing while we're about it as well. So what are we about today and what are we testing? Well, we're testing big guns. We're going for some very large cannons. So there will be some time codes down below for those that want to jump to certain sections. Now, there is a number of ways of building cannons, and we could go for multi-barreled cannons, which I have done in the previous, where you can put multiple cannons close to each other, firing at the same time, and they're almost indistinguishable from a single cannon. But at this particular time, we're just going for a single barreled, very big cannon. Reasoning behind it was that we were having some problems, basically, with a fortress, a structure, that was a long way away. And that was causing us some problems when it got further than 1600. So I want a gun that's going to do 2000 range. Now, we're also going to test, is there some limitations within the game that are going to cause us problems with the range of the gun, accuracy, also with diminishing returns and other such items, is there a practical limit to the size of cannon that we need to put in? You know, you could go stupid size of cannon, but what are the real limitations of cannons of this size? So we're going to be looking at a few bits and pieces. But the first starting point, we're going to go into build mode, is we need to start by creating a vehicle to put this all on. So this is going to be on a platform, and I'm using this platform here because once we've built it, I'm going to need to stabilize it. So we'll put our magic block in there in the first start. The first part we'll do just using the control mode, but once we start firing, I want a stable platform for fire testing. And so having this platform, we can destroy this platform if it comes to it as well. So right now, size, it's gonna be big, it's gonna be long, so we've got no problem really with, whoops, that's the wrong, let's go on to that mode for the moment. We'll put build this part in using the keyboard mode. That's 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. That's about 40 blocks. That should do as a starting point. So we're gonna need a baseline. It's gonna be long. The barrel on this is gonna be significant, but I'm not gonna go stupid. Although we're gonna see how big is too big. Other little bits and pieces I want on this, it's gonna be protected. There's no point in taking, it's gonna be expensive, this gun, and it'd be silly if you get one hit and the whole thing just blows up. That would be bad, basically, and not handy for our system. So we're gonna start with, this will be a good starting point, I think, for our cannon. So six-way connectors next. So we're gonna just go in straight in. This will also have some engines, I'm thinking, for shields and other things, which we might tag on the back or put below, etc. So we'll sort that out once we put it. Now we'll have a gun mount on the rear, sort of coming up here as a basis. I'm going to have to set 4 there, then I want 1, 2, 3 in there. Then we're gonna come out there. Okay, that's gonna be our basic gun mount, and then down here we're gonna put lots of items for various controls for it. And let's put our firing piece in now. So okay, what are the bits that I've done a limit our gun. And what do we need? Well, first of all, we do need some elevation and the number of barrels. Once you get to a certain point in the barrels, like at the moment, let me just, didn't mean to go in there. What I meant to do was just look at this. We have a reload time. We'll ignore that for the moment. So we'll go initially just looking at inaccuracy and kinetic damage. Now, they're the two items which I would see increasing with the size of the gun. So let's start with a 10 barrel gun. Now, each time I come a size, I'm going to do 50-50 motor driven, and then we're not worried about recoil here, so I'm just going to use standard barrels. So that's a 10 barrel gun. So a 10 barrel gun gets us 205. So I'm just going to write some bits down here. So that's K is 205, and let's see, our inaccuracy is 1.74. So we're going to see what the diminishing returns are here. And we've still got an elevation of 80, which is going to be important on this because we do want it to go up in the air. So, okay, we now just use this mode because it's easier for replacing. If I go into here, and so we're going to go for a 20 barrel now. So we put those five there, and then we have normal barrels. So we're going to need... so that's 10 of those, and we're going to need 10 of these. I think that should be correct. So let's just have a check of what our diminishing returns are. So two, obviously I haven't put the gauges on there, but the gauges are going to have a similar effect in that there's going to be a diminishing return on them. So 255, we can already see there's some diminishing return here, and inaccuracy 0.34. so there is a good difference between 10 and 20 barreled gun there. So let's go for the, we'll go for the 30. So let's just get in here and give myself a replace on that, and then we need to have, let's make sure I get the right ones right, five of those. And then we need a barrel. We need to add 10 more barrels on. There is one other area we're not testing at this moment, and that is the speed it takes to move this gun. Because the longer this barrel gets, the more it'll take, the slower it'll take to move around. So that will also have an effect. But in this particular instance, because we're using a fortress, it won't be really much of a problem. But certainly would be a problem if you were trying to go after, if you've got a vehicle that's moving itself, and you're trying to fire a moving moving target. Okay, so we got 305. And 0.07. So we've still got a very good return on the number of barrels. Here, there's no diminishing. We're gaining 50 kinetic damage for every 10 barrels we got, and the accuracy has been reducing quite considerably. Now we're going to get to a point where it's going to be less of a reduction. So we'll go up to the 40 barrel, I think. So we'll go on. Five of them, and then we need to put on, let's see, how many you got there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So we need to put 10 normal barrels on. Right, that I think should give us, yeah, because that was about right, because we had the base of this was about 40. So let's see what that gives us as far as, see if we're still getting any diminishings. So now we're at 355, so we've still gained 50 kinetic damage. So the kinetic damage is going up, and the accuracy 0.01. Okay, that's that's going to be, that's quite good. You know, there's no real issue there. Right, we will go, we're going to go up to 50. We're going up to 50. So that's 20. We need another 5 motor barrels. Oh, right, let's just check to make sure my elevation and everything is still correct. Yeah, 80 and 22. So that's right. Now, obviously, I haven't put any gauges on there, and we'll do the gauges next. We'll see how that has an effect. But we're just going to do the effect on the... Once we've got to a size of barrel which is suitable. So let's put another 5 of these on. So we've got 20 at the moment. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So that'd be down to 15. So we need to put 10 normal barrels on. Again, I think my maths is correct. I need to just, I'm actually going to double check to make sure that all of this, we're getting to a point where I might have made the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Yep, so another 10. Right, we're getting close to our own building now. Okay, let's see what we've got. So, kinetic damage, 405. It's still going up. There is no diminishing return at this moment. And inaccuracy is 0. I'm guessing it's so small, it's smaller than 0.01, so it's going off the scale. Now, we'll just try the 60. Although I'm thinking, I don't know, maybe 60 is going to be too big. We'll have to see. I mean, look at the size of this already. That's a sizable gun. It's bigger than the Atlantis on its own. But yes, we'll go bigger. Well, yes, yeah, maybe 60 is a good size. There's no such thing as overkill. We must remember that. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And add 10 onto the end. Should take us up to 60. Whoops, just gone off there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. That should be correct. And I did a couple there. I did a couple of doubles, but I think I did it correctly. I think I got the right numbers right. 455. Well, it's fitting in here. So 4550. So we're getting 50 kinetic each time. So the kinetic is increasing. But I will say, in my view, one thing I didn't make a note of is the amount of recoil. Now, because I'm not too worried on this, this is going to be on a fortress. But if you were using this on a turret and pointing it sideways, you could have some problems, to say the least, at this time. You could end up shooting your gun and making it turn your ship over. That would be a problem. Right, next. Gauges. Now, gauges, one thing we can't test with gauges first, but I do want to test, is the range that gauges give the gun, i.e. the maximum range it will fire at. We've already got something for, or more importantly, is it inaccuracy, accuracy, or the gauges that give it the range? What is the definer for the range of the gun? And we can only start doing that once we've got this into a situation where we'll actually fire at something. Yeah, okay, what I'm going to do is going to give this a very basic layout and make it so that it will actually join. So let's just bear with me 1 second. I'm going to make it so I'm instead of having it floating, it's going to be part of the docked on this ship here. By putting an origin block in here, we'll drop that so it drops. Yes, it's going to drop into the thing. Then we're going to go into here. Come on, come on, get me off of that. Right, we just go onto this docking station here. Select the new vehicle. We're going to put it plenty away. Let's put it 55 away for the moment. No, it doesn't mean that far. 35, I think, should be fine. 35. Select this vehicle. On. That should put it up. Now, we have got this problem of it still moving around a bit. You can see it's not perfectly stable. It's not too bad, but we do have this, or I have seen it with the other one, where you set a particular azimuth and etc., and when it goes in and out of the water, it seems to move around. Now, just at the moment, if we started firing this gun, it's going to basically blow a hole in our own ship. So we will just, for the moment, we are going to take off these bits, because we might have to make some alterations to our main ship as well for this. Now, we're going to put a very basic AI, and again, we need this covered. So let's go on to here. Oops, we're going to make sure we're building on here now. Make sure we're building on the right vehicle. There we go. And we're going to put a very simple AI. We'll put it... Where should we put it? Now, I'm going to... When it comes to the proper gun, I'm going to compartmentalize all of the items we put on this to stop any chain reactions from any of the items we put in here. But the main frame, we'll put in a secure section underneath. So at the moment, I'm just going to put it here. There we go, and put a simple wireless transmitter on it. And it will have, let's see, I'll put the other bits and pieces I will want on it, which is a left and right slot with a target prioritization, because we will want to set it to only, and an aimpoint selection, we want to set it to only shoot at big targets. As such, and then we're gonna need a place to put the controller, and from memory it's got to be near the gut firing piece to be valid. So AI, local weapon controller, put it on there, and it will need a wireless receiver. There we go. So that should be controlling one gun. Okay, fine, no problems. Now we'll put a couple of gun barrels down on here as well, just so that we have some very basic ammo barrel. I will redo these ammo barrels. This is not a permanent solution. I will do some covered ammo barrels. This is purely for testing, just to give us some shots at least at something, and some basic regeneration of weaponry. And also we'll put a let's see, a supply pump, so that it can take ammo from the main vehicle. We'll put that somewhere down near the down here, I think. And we might need a few. We'll take that one off, and we'll put a few of these in here. Whoops. There, and we need to set it so that it will accept where are we, resources, accept ammo, there we go, set that down low, and that way it will accept ammo. Right, oops, sorry, no, that's actually the wrong way. Don't give ammo, only accept it. So having it up high, that's fine. Okay, it won't give ammo to anybody. Right, now if we were to, I'm not going to spawn in a enemy ship, because that's going to be very bad. What we're going to do is just go over here and work out a certain range, which is done. It should be in range. Let's see, what range is that? That's 700 meters. And then if I now load in one of my targets, we won't have a balloon target, we just have a standard target. There we go, and we'll spawn it in the deep water guard. Load the target. Resume. There we go. And we can see this is trying to aim at it. Oh, what we'll do, we'll put a predictor on the end of this. We might as well. Edit. Custom cannon. Where are we? Predictor. There we go. So we can see what it is trying to aim at. So you can see that's got quite a high elevation already. It's not actually firing, and it actually can't. It actually can't reach it. Actually, if it's looking at this, it looks like that cannot reach that target. Quite simply, We'll check to make sure that it's not... There's no other reason why this cannon shouldn't fire. It's got no ammo, though. That is a good point. Okay, we'll give it some ammo. I think it's only fair that it should have some ammo. Okay, let's go on to here. Custom cannon. We'll put some based upon... What should we put? We need some ammo boxes anyway. So we'll put some ammo boxes on here. How are we going to load these up? I know. We'll do it like this for the moment. We will compartmentalize it, so that will be the first block, and we're going to do it in fours. 2, 3, 4, then a gap for another block, then 1, 2, 3, 4, then a block, then a block, block. Okay, that's good enough for the moment. We'll take that off there, and then we'll put some ammo boxes here just for the moment, just to get this effectively firing. So I'm not expecting this to do very much. We're not testing ammo box levels, but okay, that is firing at that item. That's 782, and it is hitting it. Well, not every time, but it is hitting it. So, yeah, that's zero gauge. So, if we look at gauges, and we look at the range that it will fire at, that's quite. It's still aiming at it. Okay, it's not going to do that. Let's just put this a little bit away. What we'll do is we'll destroy enemy vehicles. There we go. And we're going to go a little further away. So now we want to go out to 1,000 meters. No, let's go out to about 1,200. 11. That's about 1,200 meters. So load vehicle in. Resume. Are we getting any firing? So we're going to do this slightly differently. So we've got 1,200 meters. It's not shooting. It's not shooting at this target. It's obviously too far away. As we can see here, what cannot aim at target. If we go here, our inaccuracy is set at 2. So, okay, how many gauges does it need to start firing? Now, where are we going to put the gauges? Now, let's see. We're going to have 1, 2, 3. Then we're going to put them here, I think. Possibly coming off of this row here. Covering everything else, and it will act as armor at the same time. That would be a hope. Dum dum dum. There we go. Right, gauges. Right, so gauge increase. Right, 1. No. I won't worry about putting them to do it. 2, 3, 4. Okay, 4. And it did start firing at the item. Now, what has it done to our other settings? So, we've got inaccuracy is still 0, and our kinetic damage is gone up to 1196. 1196, 1200 for practically. And our ammo use has obviously gone up as well. Our reload time has gone down, understandably. As you can imagine. So we'll just go up to this here. So 4 gauges, 1200. This is also assuming this level amount of gun. And that's quite a high arc it's got there. And it's actually not that accurate. It's not hitting that many times, to be frankly honest. It is sort of hitting, but not as much as I would expect for that number of barrels. But a large target, that would be hitting every single time, just about. So that's okay. Okay, let's destroy that and go a little bit further. So what are we going to look out for now? 1500? 1500. Load vehicle. Load a target. Is this going to start farming? I'm thinking not. Not initially. So there we go. That's not working. It's not firing. So let's put some more gauge increases in until it starts firing. That's 6, 7, 8. 8. Okay. So 8 was okay at 1500. Let's check the other values. And reload was 4.4. So we got inaccuracy is still going, so that's fine. Kinetic damage is up to 1682. So that's increasing. It's just double, but it's a diminishing return. And our reload time has gone down to 6.24. So that's also increasing, but it's not exponential. Seems to be just a minor increase. But let's now go and have a look, see how accurate this is. See if it's actually hitting. It's going a little over the top. It's not actually being that accurate. They're mainly going over. Don't know if that's an issue with the particular target. Are we getting some hits? Oh yeah, okay, it is hitting on occasion. So they're not all going over. Right, okay, let's go to the next stage then. So this is just a matter of going a little bit at a time. So where are we? We were at 15, so let's try 1800. I think 1800 would be the next, well, it's not next logical stop, logical step, but I think I quite like the idea of it. Okay, so let's load that target in at 1800. Because it's also an extra 300 more. We had 1200, then 1500, now we've got 1800. So let's go back to our gun. Where are we? Where are you? There you are, sir. Let's put some more gauges on you, sir, shall we? So, 1, 2, 3. No, let's see if that fourth one does it. No, that one didn't give us that magical move. So we've got a diminishing return. Let's put one more on. No, 2, 3, 4. So no, that we're not up to that range at the moment. But we'll make a note of this. Oh, hang on. Ooh, barely. 1800-ish for, how many is that? That's 16. I think, let's make a note of these figures. Inaccuracy is still zero. That's a function of barrel length at the moment. 2211, so we're now getting a diminishing return now, or starting to, for the damage. It's still 400, but it's starting to get... reload 8.2, so that's starting to get a little worse. Okay, so just about 1800 we got with this gun. Okay, well, just let's go and have a check over this end. Dun 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 dun. How's it doing with its kinetic damage? Is it hitting in? Here we come in with a sizable shell. Oh no. It's a big ass shell that's being fired, I've got to say. Let's just make sure we're still 1803. Ooh, yeah, that does a bit of damage when that hits, and it killed the AI. That does. It's possible to kill it with one shot. Okay, well, we're going to destroy that because we're going to go a little further. We're going to go to the 2000 mark, just under. because this is a bit where I want to test if there's an issue with 2000 meters. So 1991 from the AI. Load vehicle, load target. Okay, is our gun, our gun's not aiming. The man from Gun Monty, he says no. So how many do we need? 1, 2, 3, 4. So we're now up to, let's see, 20. Still not getting it. So we're getting a diminishing return on the gun, on the range. So let's try and put another 4 in. No, not so far. Okay, we are not getting anything so far. Let's have a look for this number of gauges. We are still not getting let's have a look at our inaccuracy. So we're up to 8, 16, 24, 32 blocks, and we're still not getting a hit, targeting. So that's a, we're just going to make some notes of it. Inaccuracy is still 0, 2, 5, 3, 6, and we've got a 9.41. So, okay, so how many do I need? Let's put some more in. 1, 2, 3, 4. Another. Oh, finally. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So that's, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So that's 40 gauges. Finally hit, starts firing at 1991. That's a lot of gauges, I have to say. And let's just check the figures. 2578. So, where are we? 2578. Accuracy 0 and 9.56. Now, the reload time, difference between 32 and 40, was actually fairly minimal. So reload time's not expanding. The damage, though, the difference between 32 to 40 is only about 30 damage. So certainly we're reaching a point where the damage of the kinetic is not really making that much difference. So, okay, now I want to test one thing, is can this fire at targets, so I think we've got to a point where near the 2000 range, you're effectively got a good sized gun here, 60 barrel, 40 gauge. Obviously we can work on some of the others. You can see it's having a problem trying to aim, but now we're now going to have a look at, can it fire at something beyond 2,000 metres? A range of 2,000. Or is there an issue with the AI targeting over 2,000? So we're going to go to 2,100. And that's close enough. Right, so this is going to be this is as much as anything. This is a test for is there an AI limitation? So we'll put another 4 in. That's another 8. Yeah, nothing so far. Okay, we'll put 4 in there. No, yeah, don't want to know. Okay. No, not so far. Nope, we haven't got anything. Still not aiming. Still not aiming. Okay, let's just see if it's ever done the aim. And we'll just go. So, I don't know how many gauges that is now. I lost count there somewhere. let's see. You can see here, even though I've put all of those gauges in, let's just make sure that they are connecting. Connected, connected. These are also connected. Connected to firing piece, yep. So, we've got a significant number of gauges there. The actual damage has hardly gone up much. I would guess we've got, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Oh, okay, hang on. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 16s. So that's 96, 7, 8, 9, 10. That's about 100 gauges there. So 100 gauges. Still didn't get us above 200. The damage, the recoil is 11,000. that's quite high, really. We had 2,610 damage, reload time 9.68. So compare that to our 40 gauge. 40 gauge was 2,578. So over 2,578 to 2,610, we've hardly gained anything. You know, that's 30. Whatever, you know, 32 or whatever points, that's not worth it for an extra 60 gauges. Reload time's not gone up much, but so definitely the sweet point seems to be around 40. There's no point in going above that, really. Now we'll just take it down a little bit. I'll take off this bottom row. I don't want to do it with the keyboard key because it's got a tendency to go completely and utterly mad on me and I end up taking too much off. Because sometimes I'm like that. Okay, so now we're down to a more manageable level. Let's see what the 2.6. See, I took off that whole row, and that's still only gone down to 2.609. So that was one kinetic damage for that. About 30 odd gauges. So yeah, definitely not worth going too high, and I'm even thinking that this top row is not going to be worth it. We'll take off a few of these. Let's see, it's 4. We're not gaining anything from having these ones on the top here either. Okay, so that looks like that's as good a place as any. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We've actually got a little bit over. We've got 6. We've actually got 48 here. So that's 48. Two, five, 9, 7, which is close enough. Reload time 9.63. Inaccuracy is still good. And if I put something out just under the 2000 range, so let's see here, 1774, that's a little, need to get a bit closer, 2021, 1987, 1994, that's as close as we'd need to get. It should start firing this. Now, it could be that Nick, at some point in the future, may change the range of the AI to allow it to shoot at targets further than this away. At which point, we could then look at a slightly different. Now, how high an angle is that having to fire at? We can see it trying to fire. Now, one thing is, yep, that's good. That's firing. That's firing okay. I'm okay with that. So that it started to fire at our just about 2,000 target. If we go back, I wouldn't be surprised if I go back here. There's mostly having some problems with the rocking, slight rocking motion of this platform because of the number of gauges on it. So okay, but that's a good starting point. Now I'll just I'll gonna leave that out there for the moment, just as a marker point. Next stage. Yes. Bing bada boom. Right. And high explosive. So AP rating. So at the moment, with no armor piercing blocks, we've got an AP rating, I think, of 3. Whoops. Go there. Let's get into build mode. So we're just going to test the AP rating. So that's an AP rating of 3 as the starting point. So let's just put a few armor piercing warheads. Now we're going to do it down here. And we're going to do in fours. So we're going to see how many that 4 did. So 4 gave us 6.4. Now, gauge is not really going to have an effect on armor piercing. It's only going to have an effect with other bits. Right, now we'll put 4 more. And this is all part of this idea of compartmentalizing. So that's why I'm doing it in blocks of 4 here. So now we're up to 8. And we've gone to 8.7. Okay, next one, 12. Let's see if it's diminishing. 10.2, so it's definitely going down. Now, at this point, your AP is enough to penetrate metal, because metal has an AP of 10, and also shields have a maximum AP resistance of 10. So, but we'll take it a little higher, because every little bit, we want to see at what point it just isn't worth doing. So let's have a look at that. 11.1 for 16. 11.1. I'm making a note of these. That's why I'm taking a second, so I can refer to them later on. Let's put another 4 in. See how far this goes. We're looking at 11.8. You can see that diminishing return now, but it is getting a little bit better. But you're starting to get to question, you know, is it worth going much further? So we'll put another. We'll go up to the list. It'll put us up to 24, I think it is, and we're now up to that 12.2. We're 24. We'll go a little bit further. We'll put some in there. Now, I think that's most probably, that's enough to penetrate most things, armor and most shields at 12.2. You're starting to get a diminishing return. So I'm just going to put some in here, which I'm going to get. So that's 28. And we've just made another 0.3. Now, that might be worth doing. Okay, we'll put another 8 in. That's 12.8. So we've now got 12.7. So, yeah, we're now starting to get serious problems with returns. That's a 0.1. Excuse me. A 12.1 change. For, let's see, how many have I got on there now? We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So that's 4 sixes, that's 36, 46, 58. For 58, you're now only getting 0.1 difference for each of your additional blocks. We're going to load it up though. I'm going to put some more on. Let's just take this up to some sort of limit or conclusion. So there we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 six eights. So we're looking at a nice figure there. My brain is having a bit of a I should know this off top of my head, so it's 3 16s. 32 48. Let's say 8 8 8 16 24 32 40 48. Okay, 48 is 12.9. Right, let's measure that up against 24, which is half the number. Half the number, so you imagine all of the resources that are required, gives you 12.2. So you're only getting 0.7 for double the number of boxes. My view, that's not worth it. You know, subjective. I don't think that 0.7 is worth all of that extra AP. All those extra boxes. I'm going to leave them on this one, just for the moment. I might leave them on there. But reality, if you're trying to be a little bit more resource, less resource intensive, you'd only want the 24. So 24 would be a good number to use. Right, now I'm going to just do HE. Let's see if we've got the same issue with the high explosive. Where am I going to put them? I know, I'll put them temporarily. I'm going to put them on the top here. So we're going to start off with 4. Actually, I need to take a note of what the 0 figure is. So the HE 0 figure, ilf, with this number of gauges, is what? 0. Okay, so, well, that's really handy then. That's a good starting point. Right, let's put 4 on. And that's given us a nice HE of 196. And then we'll do another 4. And that's given us 325, so that's a good increase. That'd be worth it. That'd be worth doing. $409. Starting to reduce, but still good. $465. So definitely now we're getting only less than 50, well, about 50%, just over 50 damage point. So we're up to 20. 20 is the 501. So it's actually still increasing. This could be it could be worth having the HE box barrels on this, the HE boxes. Let's go up to, we're up to the 24 mark. 24 is giving us 525. So okay, we're now definitely down on the return. We'll put some more in though. We're gonna start doing it a little higher now because our returns are less. So I'm gonna put 8 in now. So that will take us up to 24, 32. 32 is 551. 551. Yeah, okay, that's not too bad. It's definitely down. We'll put another 8 in. So we're up to 40. 562. Starting to get very limited. Benefit last 8. This will take us up to 48, so it'd be about the same as we've got in the AP. And that's given us 567. So that last 8 only gave us 5 HE difference. So yeah, I now at this point really seriously think of justification for going any further would be awkward or difficult to justify, basically, at this level. Just not done a... It's not worth it, quite frankly, in my view. So, you know, possibly 48, possibly. I would most probably stick at 24. I don't think that, again, it's the same with the difference. 24 is 525, 48 was 567. For that, I would prefer to have a second gun with 24 rather than a single gun with these 24. It's worth, you're getting to a point where it's worth having more guns than it is more items. So I'm going to take off the top row for our gun. I'm going to take off the top row of these items, and that will be what our gun will use, 24. So I'd rather have two of these, save the resources, all the metal that it takes to build that, and build a second gun. With the armor piercing, I'm going to leave these ones on for the moment, although, to be honest, I would still, I'd find it difficult justifying those as well. Frankly honest, I'd mostly go down to 24 of them as well. Okay, so where are we left with? Reloads. Now, we're going to do these in a slightly different numbered order. Ammo boxes and reloads. We're at 9.63 at the moment, so the reload figure, obviously 0 is 0. 3, we've got 9.63. And this is, the reload speed is relevant to gauge. So we won't change the gauge on this. We're just going to add some more boxes. So we'll add another 3 in. So up to 6. 406. And that made a significant difference. Just those 3 boxes. Excuse me. Right. That's too many. We'll put another 3 on. I'm using these, obviously, these reloaders with one reloader and putting the maximum on. So we've got 1.71. So that's 9, 1.71. That's still made. That's made a significant difference. Again, it seems to be not following the normal path. Now we'll put this 3 on, which is going to take us up to 12. 12.72. So now we're getting difficult. You know, it's not compensating the same. Want of a better word. It's not diminishing at the same rate. Whoops. That's another 3. So, okay, we're going to get close to not needing 3 now. So this is going to be 15. And I may change it in a second to the rate how many I'm adding. So 15 is 0.57. So, yep, starting to diminish. So let's take this up to... let's see, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. Let's take it up to 24. So it seems to be a good magic number so far, 24. So we've got a rate, that's only still 0.57. So that's the same as 15. That didn't have any effect. So let's just confirm that. If I fill in all of these ones, so that's adding a whole load more. So that's taking it up to 36, I think. 0.57. So there is a limit to the reload time. And it is at 15 ammo boxes on these items. Now I'm going to continue to use these, but so that's interesting. Yeah, that's very interesting. That's given us a limit as to how many ammo boxes on these you would need. Now, it means that if you were building this, you can still use ammo autoloaders because they give you 3 sections, but a 6-way connector costs you 60 scrap, 60 metal. How much does an autoloader cost you? Actually, yeah, auto loader is cheaper. It's better although you still need a six-way, it's better to have ammo boxes and that connected to auto loaders than it is six-way connectors, according to that. Except you can't stack auto loaders next to each other. But if you were building a section and you wanted to get as many items as possible onto it, it means that it would actually be resource-wise better to do something like this. And then put your boxes on everything, because you can still put your explosive on here, etc. So do that rather than having this sort of design. So it's more resource intensive to use auto loaders. Okay, that's just an item, but definitely no need for more than 15 auto loaders for actual reload time. So okay, now what I'm gonna do, so we got some good stats here for guns as to what is the theoretical maximum for a gun. Now let's go through inaccuracy. Let's see what the inaccuracy is. So it still shows zero, but I don't know what the actual, but actually it was 40 barrels seemed to be the sweet spot for that. 40 gauges still gave us a 0.01 inaccuracy, so that's a sweet spot. You could save your gauges on that, although it did increase the kinetic damage. It was still increasing, and the kinetic damage is increasing, not exponentially. There doesn't seem to be a decrease in that, but the real decrease in that is this speed it takes to aim. Now, looking at our gun at the moment, I'm thinking I might bring it down to a 50 barrel, just for sheer. So this is the number. Sorry, this is the number of barrels, not gauges. The number of barrels. I might bring it down to a 50, just for sheer size. So I might do that. Just convert that over. Let's see, where else are we? Gauges. So where is the sweet spot with gauges? Gauges, range-wise, 40. We were getting 1991. So 40 gauges seems to be good, because the AI will not shoot at something further away than 2,000 meters at the moment. So no need to go that high. So 40 seems to be the sweet spot in gauges. The increase at that point in kinetic damage, although we were getting, I mean, if you remember, we went up to 100 pieces, and kinetic damage wise the difference was so little it was not worth it. You know, it was only about, for 100, you know, twice as many gauges and you've got all the resources there, you're only getting a smaller increase. So again, you need the 40 gauges to get that range, but don't need to go above that for damage. And what was the next one? AP and HE. Let's see. AP, 20. It's still going up. 24, 30. You know, 48 was getting us 12.9. But 24 was 12.2. So again, yeah, 24 could be the sweet spot, but there is something, if you really want to get that last little bit of armor piercing, yeah, go up to the 48. But again, sweet spot, maybe have two cannons at 24 is better than one cannon at 48. This is must we stick with 48 on this one. HE, diminishing return. We were getting, let's see, 525, 24, 32. So HE was going up a little bit better, so there is some benefit of having a higher HE. Although we did have it at 24 was 525, doubling that only gave us about 30 more. So again, 24, I'd rather have two guns at 24 than one gun at 48. So on this gun, we're most probably gonna go for 48, just for, because, you know, why not? But it'd be better to have two guns if you were looking at a turret on an actual ship, you would taunt two guns with 24, not one gun with 48. And finally, reloading, ammo boxes. Ammo itself is required to sustain the gun, but it seems like 15, after you get to 15 boxes, it doesn't actually improve your rate of fire at all. It's, that seems to be the sweet spot in that regard. Okay, right, so hopefully that information has been useful. So, you know, it looks like 24s a nice number, seems to be for most items. What I'm now going to do is I'm going to fill out this gun. I'm going to basically sort out, based on these figures, I'm going to move the HE down to here. I'm going to segment each of these by putting, basically the plan is to put some metal beams between each of these segments to act as like a firewall between each segment area, so that it's only got the six way going between, so that if there's an explosion in one section, it's unlikely to blow the whole next section up. So that's the intention there. Have a whole row of, or two rows of metal here, three rows of metal here, and metal all around the gun. Yes, a lot of metal. So I'll get that situation set up, and then you can come back and see the results and a little bit of combat testing against something, just to see how much damage and accuracy this has and what sort of fire rate we can get out of it. It's only got a 0.57, but let's see what damage we end up getting. So we've been going on quite a while, so this won't be a time lapse. This will just be a straight see you in a little while. And welcome back to the Dora Siege Pod. Yes, it's going to be nicknamed Dora after the World War II gun. It's the only suitable name. Although, you know, because the Paris gun, which was where Dora came from, sort of thing. Although you could have had Anzio Annie. I suppose I could have made it the Onyx Annie or something like that. But anyway, this is the gun as such. I've left it with the 60 barrels for the moment. Most of the others I left at 48. So our actual end figure at the moment, if I bring the interface back on, I'll go into build mode so I don't move around too much. If I can find the firing piece in here somewhere. Almost got it. It's here somewhere. Come on, there we go. So, reload time 0.57, which was the 15 ammo boxes, but I've increased the ammo boxes to 36, just so that it's got that good ammo supply. Kinetic damage 2500, explosive 558. So they're all based upon the sizes we'd worked out. It's a little bit lower. I'd basically gone to 48 on each of the items, because we are just going for a single gun in this particular case. Despite everything we'd worked out to say 24, we are in this case going for the single big gun. Now the recoil, 10,936 recoil. Excuse me. Now in a normal ship, that's a flipping load of recoil. Frankly, that would tip ships over, basically. So we'd have to be you'd have to be very careful with that. So we've got a nice little sighting system. If you wanted to do a manual sighting system, we've got some sort of manual sight. But reality is, we're gonna let it attack targets. So how does it do? Well, let's go over here and load something in. So let's just, what's our range here? 1400, let's go a little bit further. 1700, okay, let's just load in a standard let's load in a Telemachus. That seems like a reasonable ship. Can't load anything too large in. If I've loaded anything too large in, basically our fort's not defensive. So here we go. Now it's not great because these shells take a while to come in, so it's going to take a while to predict, but let's see, they are destroying at quite well. Yes, it's fair to say that's not lasting too long. Okay, let's give it something a little bit bigger. Let's get a little bit further away. Let's test this maximum range. So we're going to get it just over the 2000 mark. There we go. So we know it's not going to fire initially. And then we're loading. Let's load something big. What would be a good ship to go against? Okay, this could destroy us, but let's try a Warden. It's a big ship. It will fire back, but let's see who gets the shots in first. And this is at 2,000 meter range. So we'll see who shoots first. See if he does get shots in, or whether it's a one-way street. Let's find the 2,000 mark. So let's about here. So we should start seeing some shots come in as soon as he gets near this line, in theory. So he's gone across the line. The AI should be saying, hello, meet Dora. Dora has a message for you. It's encased in steel and HE, and high explosive and armor piercing. Yes, that's relatively effective. Now I will put some limitations on the gun, because I only want this firing at long distance, large targets. No point in trying to shoot at small targets. As you can see, even here, this speed of vessel, because it's suddenly going sideways, it is having a problem readjusting to it. It's eventually getting there, but it takes a while for it to readjust. That's due to the number of barrels, etc. It has a problem readjusting, but that's just sheer good damage. If you wanted to make that more, either make it a multi-barrel gun or put more of them out there, quite simply. But yep, that's rather effective at long range. So that's a good long range gun ready for us. You can see it hasn't got too much. It's got a little bit there. If we have to aim it, what we will do is basically aim the whole ship, the Atlantis is our aim. And we'll set the AI. Oh, this is a little noisy. Excuse me for that, but it's the nature of a big gun. Can you imagine the guys how noise it was made when they were working in the Dora? Some little known facts about the Dora. Obviously it was I'll set the minimum range at about 1200, I think. Won't have a maximum, and say only fire at things that have got 2000 blocks, I think. Less than that, and I don't think it's worth shooting at. We're going to be going for large targets. The other normal guns will quite happily deal with it. So that's the limitation on that. Yeah, Dora. It was its own battalion. Dora was, by the Krupp's work, used. The only time it was really used was against Sevastopol, I believe, where it basically blew up concrete bunkers, which were thought to be impregnable. It needed two railway tracks next to each other, which were specially built for it, and it had its own set of trains for moving it around. It was only used once, very expensive. Whole battalion, there was a second battalion attached to it, which just had AA guns. I can't remember the exact number of people, but it was good, like 500 people needed to look after the gun. And each of the shells were numbered and were fired consecutively, because the bore of the cannon would wear every time it was shot, and they had to use a new shell which had the correct bore every time it shot. And they'd have to also recalculate how much powder charge etc. would be required for the new shot to keep the same accuracy. Impressive gun, totally impractical in real world, but it had one glorious moment. There was the smaller version, which was became Anzio Anni, which was a single rail carriage gun. It wasn't a double size, the same as Dora. Then there was, which I was also thinking about building, there was the mortars that were created. They were Odin, Thor. I can't remember the other names, but I remember the last two were actually called Adam and Eve. The first four, I think, were called after Norse gods, and the last two were Adam and Eve. And they were large mortars. But yeah, anyway, a little bit of trivia. Look it up on Wikipedia. It's fairly accurate, the Wikipedia one. So it's always a bit of fun. This is Dora. This will be joining the Atlantis as a spawned-in pod on the back of it. We'll have to work out the spawning point so that it doesn't destroy the whole of... Because if this fires, anything in front of this barrel, when it fires, will be destroyed. So we might have to move those rear missile, or I'm going to have to offset this from the rear centre so that it only fires through or something. Because it'll blow up anything that's in front of it. It's a little susceptible to damage if the barrel here gets chopped off, but I don't think it'll get hurt. I've got some shields on there. It's got a lot of metal on here, as you can see, protecting everything. So yeah, that's Dora. Welcome to the campaign. Hopefully you found the first parts about all of the gauges and the large cannons interesting. And this is the latest build for big guns. So until next time, keep playing the game, comment down below. My next one will be actually longer range missiles, actually, I believe. I might look at that as the next pod, but any other great ideas, please put them down below. Click that like button, but until next time, have fun.